So what's up guys, welcome back to another video, and in today's video we're going to be disassembling and reassembling this Coleman 196cc engine that came off of this mini bike right here. I didn't need it anymore, this engine had a lot of problems. I did take it apart multiple times, but I'm just going to be showing you how to disassemble it, reassemble it, and everything you need to know about these small little engines. Let's get into it. Okay, the first thing you're going to want to do is remove this oil drain plug right here. It is a 10 mil bolt, so grab yourself a ratchet and a 10 mil and we'll get right into doing an oil change on it. This engine has been sitting outside in the rain, so we're gonna see if any oil got inside the engine. Inside the engine. So it's loosening right here. Make sure it's still in place. Once you take that. I do have a catch pan right under this. And some of this oil was used because I didn't have any new oil. But as you can see, it's draining out perfectly fine. There are a little bit of metal shavings. I'll get a close up of this in a second. But I do have a magnetic oil dipstick. Now, since the oil is done draining, you're gonna go ahead and reinsert the oil drain plug right here. Just like so. And tighten it down. All of these engines have a gas thing that sit right here. They will sit right here with two 10 mil bolts right here. I'll put a video or a clip or something of how the bolts look like when they're on there. Plus, there is one other bolt on this side right here. Right there, that one. You remove that one and then the gas thing will slide right off. Now, depending if your engine is stock or not, this one has a stage one on it. You're gonna wanna remove the air filter, just like this. See, this is the stage one air filter from Go Power Sports. And right when you remove the air filter, you will see two 10 mil bolts right here, which will take your ratchet again, and unscrew the bolts, which were extremely loose. They were finger tight, and you wanna go ahead and completely remove those. The two bolts have been removed right here, then this should slide off. Or if you have the stock style one, the air box should slide off just as easily as that. So we'll go ahead and put these off to the side so we do not lose them. We have your gasket right here. You have your carb, which should have some type of throttle cable linking it. Since this is governor removed, I have this spring right here. You could have some other throttle linkage which would sit right here. It looks something like this right here. So you want to remove that. It would be just an 8 mil bolt right there and one right here. After you have this removed right here, it's your carburetor. This is what delivers the fuel into your engine. We'll be taking this apart later. You want to set this aside so you don't lose this one either. You should have your gasket and your spacer with a gasket on both sides, just like this. Okay, now to remove the exhaust, you have two 13 millimeter bolts right here. This is where the power tools come in. And if you don't have power tools, a ratchet will work, or a wrench, or whatever you have. Just make sure it's 13 mil. So, one bolt like that, one like that. We'll go ahead and put these bolts aside so we don't lose them. This exhaust will come off with two lock washers right here, which will go wherever you need them so you don't lose them. Your exhaust gasket, and then your exhaust. Now we're gonna go ahead and remove your fan shroud right here, which would just be a couple 8 mil screws. And this should slide right off to reveal your flywheel. Well, over here, we're gonna go ahead and remove the ignition coil. Two 8 millimeter screws. Next, we'll go ahead and remove the spark plug with a 3/4 spark plug boot right here, just like that. And make sure you use your ratchet and not an impact because you can break your spark plugs. Right here, spark plugs are really tight. Gotta make sure. There you go, just like that. You should have your spark plug coming out just like so. So now that we have the spark plug removed, we can check on it. As you can see, it's burning perfectly fine. Removing the flywheel can be one of the trickiest parts. You will need a 19 millimeter socket and an impact. If you don't have an impact, you're gonna have to have some way to hold your crankshaft while turning it, because if you use a socket like this, you're just going to turn over your engine just like that and you're not gonna be able to loosen anything. So you need an impact just like that, and you'll fire on the starter cup and the plastic fan here, because I'm gonna show you a trick you probably already know on how to remove your flywheel. So you wanna find the strongest part of the block, which is right here. If I can get this in there, put pressure on it, and then smack the flywheel nut. Just like that. Take off your flywheel nut again. And your flywheel will come off like this. Next thing we're gonna do is remove the cylinder head, but first you're gonna have to remove the valve cover with 4 8-mil screws. Put those in a safe place so you don't lose anything, and the valve cover should come right off with the gasket. Okay, me from the future here, I just realized I didn't film myself taking off the cylinder head, so I'm gonna explain it to you really fast right now. You have 4 12-millimeter bolts, 2 on top and 2 inside your valve cover. One of mine was missing, so forget about that one. But anyways, continuing with the video. When you pull off your cylinder head, you should have these 2 push rods that slide right into the block. These are very important. Don't lose them, don't drop them, don't bend them. You need these to stay exactly the same. This is the head gasket that came with the engine. It is a 10,000th head gasket. Not all head gaskets will be like this. Most of them will be a paper, metal material, and it will get stuck on your engine, and you're most likely gonna have to buy another one. These are also very important. These are the dowels to make sure that your head lines up perfectly when you bolt it back on. Do not lose these. They could be here or here, depending on where they were when you took apart your engine. So grab your impact and take apart your bolts. There you have all your bolts right here. Make sure those are in a safe spot. And then you're gonna wanna go ahead and pull off your side cover. Be careful, because the gasket 100% of the time rips, but I've been lucky to take this engine apart like 3 times and have no gasket problem. These 196 cc's and 224 cc's come with a nylon camshaft, which just comes out right here. As you can see, the lobes and the shaft are made of metal. Ouch. And then the nylon cam gear is made out of nylon right here, which is a type of plastic. I don't like these because the teeth can break. And then we have the lifters. Be careful with these. These are very important as well. Don't lose these. These are what your cam rides on to push the valves up. So far, I'm not seeing any sign of water damage. It's only been outside once in the rain. So these 196s do not come with an oil sensor from the factory. As you can see, there's a spot to mount them right here, but there's no spot for an oil sensor. Also, there will be a governor if you're running a stock engine, but this one has a governor delete, so there's no governor, which makes it slightly easier. Okay, I have barely managed to unscrew the rod bolts right here. They are very tight, just beware of that. As I unscrew them, I just want to be very careful with these there. See, that looks perfectly fine, good to reuse. Now, here comes your rod cap. This looks like it's fine, doesn't have that much wear on it. Then you have your oil dipper that mixes all the oil around, making sure everything's nice and lubed up. This is perfectly fine, there's nothing wrong with this one either. Time to pull out the pistons. So you're gonna push the rod from this side out the top. It's a little tricky, but once you get it, it's not that difficult. Boom, we have our piston right here. We'll go in depth to all the details about all the engine parts in a minute, but time to pull out your crankshaft. It's a rotating assembly, you could call it. So just like that. Your crankshaft to come out. No governor gear on this side. If you want to remove the governor, I'd recommend punching out the gear. really simple. We're down to the bare block. One thing I did forget to mention is that these blocks do have heat shields that sit right here. This one didn't have it because I removed it before the video. But now that it's disassembled, you can wash the block, do whatever you want with it, and then we'll get to reassembling it.